In this video, I'm going to talk about how to create a data entry form with Streamlit. You can use this form to update your data in a CSV file. This is very important because we can combine data from different CSV files to compile the whole accounting set, like what we did in Excel before. This approach has an additional benefit as we can break down the data entry process. In other words, we can achieve segregation of duties. You will find it helpful when your company goes big. Alright, let's begin. First of all, let me open up the CSV file. It's like this. What I want is update this CSV file. This CSV file has three columns: reference, name, and age. 4, 5, 6. Whenever I press this button, the reference will add one automatically, like 3 to 4 or 4 to 5. Here, input some name. I put in a name. Enter age. After pressing this, the CSV file will be updated automatically. I didn't expect it to be complicated because it already has a system index column and my own reference. What I first did was df.set to index to the ref, but it didn't work. I'm not gonna try here as I don't want to break it. Rerun it. It should be okay. Which should be this one. The table you see here is before, so we can add a line of code so that it's easier to understand. Before update, okay. It just shows the record from the CSV, only three records here. I also have an st.write down here. Let me add some code here. After update, save it. Before update and after update. Come here and input some name. This is the sidebar. Let me close the sidebar. Open it again, which is here. Give it a key called form1 for clear on submit. When I press submit, it will return the default value. So this is the form. The highlight area is the text input field, which is here with label elite. Here I want to test if Chinese and Japanese text, the UTF-8 encoding, and my label is name_label with the jap elite, and the default value is input some name. Here I can change it to input one name, save it. Here you see input one name. The default value can also be changed here. Press tab to go down a field and shift tab to go back. The age here works pretty much the same. The only difference is enter age that's set here. Here comes the most tricky part, reference. In my accounting Excel, the entries will follow 1, 2, 3, 4, which is a rolling sequence. It will be used to concat data such as purchase and sales by utilizing the number range to join those tables. Since purchase and sales have different fields, and I don't want to use join method, that kind of thing, therefore, I use my reference. Let's say purchase is 1 to 10, sales is 11 to 20, interbank whatever, and so on. That's why I create a field called @ref, which doesn't require manual entry. And you don't see @ref inside the sidebar. Instead, I make it auto @1. This is an increment, which is based on this table called df and its reference columns maximum number. If it's 1, 2, 3, then the max is 3. If it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, then the max is 6. Then add 1 to the maximum. I move on to this button press. This button press is form.function called form submit button. For the label, I use the jap pulesu. Here, the button label, I use an F string to wrap around the variable. This is the form that we just defined. We are still working on the sidebar. In case of button press, which is this form button, is true unless otherwise specified. Then the variable new data, which is a dictionary that wraps around the reference column, and this name column and age column. Here, this colon refers to the @reference, add name and add age. Here I make the age an integer. Before I press it, I enter whatever. Then I press submit. You should see my update here. After the press, the reference becomes 4, right? And the name is whatever. The age is 0 as I didn't enter anything. It just returns whatever I entered, right? The ref automatically adds 1. If I don't do anything, it will show fill in the form. Let me add one more. The 5th. And then 18. Press submit. And you see the record added. Let me show you. I've updated this CSV file. Here under after update. Reference 4, whatever. H is 0. Reference 5 is the 5th. And then 18, right? Done. Indeed, I create a delete button below, but it doesn't work. I'll try it tomorrow. Indeed, when you get the reference worked, the rest of it is just a piece of cake. They are just query, filter, pivot table, those kind of pandas built-in library. It can be done with a single line of code, which is just like the last video that I finished trial balance with one line of code. Alright, that's it for today. Ciao.